everyone. Mobile computing is a very interesting topic, which is on mobile technology, where we use mobile phones in our day-to-day life. We all carry our mobile phones or smartphones with us. Why? Since it helps us to communicate with our friends or relatives.
The whole mobile technology, whatever we use in our mobiles, everything comes under mobile computing. The mobile computing is the way to the future. It allows people to work independently from home by saving time. Now next we go with what actually the word mobile computing means. Mobile computing is a generic term that refers to a variety of devices that allow people to access the data, get information, whatever they need. Sometimes referred to as human-computer interaction. It is nothing but the interaction between the human and computer. Mobile computer will allow us to transmit the data, voice and video over a network. Now, this mobile computing will have many benefits. The first one is location flexibility. This helps the users to work from anywhere as long as there is a connection established. The second benefit is connectivity. You can stay connected to all the network sources at any time. The next benefit is social network. You can interact with variety of people from different countries through internet. The next one is saving time. Now what actually is, in olden days, the people used to submit their documents or files by traveling from different location in order to go to their office and submit those documents. So, but now, using this mobile computing devices, one can now access their documents. They can send the documents and files from anywhere with only one click. Now the next benefit is ease of research. Research has been made easier since users earlier, what they used to do is they used to go to the field and search for the facts, and then later they used to feed them in back into the system. But now what actually going on is they made easier for field officers and researchers to collect and feed data from wherever they are without making unnecessary trips or traveling to and from the office to fields. And the next benefit is on entertainment. Now, videos and audio recordings can now be streamed on the go using mobile computing. It is very easy to access a wide variety of movies, educational videos and some informative material. And this is all done through internet. The last benefit of mobile computing is streamlining of business processes. Business processes are now easily available through secure connection, right? Looking into security issues, there are many adequate measures have been put into place to ensure authentication and authorization of user accessing the services. Now, in business, we see meetings and seminars and other informative services. They easily conduct those meetings and seminars using video and voice conference. Now, this will reduce the traveling time and the expenditure. Now, let's go to the other topic, mobile and handheld devices. The invention of the mobile phone is great success of science. No doubt, mobile phone has changed our lifestyle. Now, we see what is mobile, what actually the definition of mobile is. The mobile phone is a device that is used to make calls or to send messages to our near or dear ones. It can also be used in multi-purpose tasks. In addition to calls or messages, the mobile phone can also be used as calculator, camera, voice recording, audio and video player, etc. And also one can browse the internet on his or her mobile phone. Now, what is handheld devices?
Handheld is any portable device that can be carried and held in one's palm. Now again, what is portable device? Okay, portable device is nothing but the device that can easily be carried from one place to another. A handheld can be any computing or electronic device that is compact and portable enough to be held and used in one or both hands. It is primarily designed to provide a suite of computing, communication, and informational tools in a device about the size of standard palm. Earlier, handheld devices are not powerful as a computer, but modern handheld devices increasingly include powerful dual-core processors, RAM, SD storage capacity, and operating system. And also with many applications. As they are powered by the dry cell lithium batteries, these type of devices increasingly used a touchscreen interface. Now we are aware about the handheld devices. Now let's see about the types of handheld devices. There are typically three types of handheld devices. There are mobile computers, media recorders, and the third one is communication devices. Let's see each of them in briefly. The first one is mobile computers, and in that we have notebook PC. This comes under this category, which was introduced in the year 1981. It is an extremely lightweight PC. Notebook typically weigh less than 6 pounds and are small enough to fit easily in briefcase. They use different techniques known as flat panel technologies in order to produce a lightweight. And the next one is handheld PC. This was introduced in the year 1989, which is the computer that can conveniently be stored in a pocket. The third mobile computer is ultra mobile PC, which is introduced in the year 2006. It is also denoted as UMPC, which is a Microsoft team that refers to the handheld device capable of running Microsoft's stable PC operating system. It is larger than PDA and smaller than laptop. The next type is personal digital assistant. This was introduced in the year 1993. It is a term for small mobile handheld device that provides computing and information storage and retrieval capabilities for person or business use, often for keeping schedules, calendar and all, etc. The next one is graphical calculators. This was introduced in the year 1990. A graphing calculator is a calculator device that has the ability to display plotted graphs for complex equations such as parabolas and other plotted results. The next is Pokemon Mini. This was introduced in the year 2001. It is a handheld game console that was designed and manufactured by Nintendo. It is the smallest game system with interchangeable cartridges ever produced by Nintendo, weighing just under 2.5 pounds. Now, the second type of handheld devices is mobile recorders. And in that, we have again different categories. The first one is digital still camera. This was introduced in the year 1975. This is a type of camera. It is used to take photographs. Digital cameras use electronics, usually a charge-coupled device, to store digital images in computer memory inside the camera. The digital image can be transferred to the computer for later processing. The second type is digital video camera, which was introduced in the year 1986. A digital video camera recorder or digital camcorder is a device that records video to formats including digital 8, mini DV, DVD, a hard drive or solid state memory, flash memory. So some digital camcorders can even record a high definition quality. Next, the third type is digital audio recorders, and this introduced in the year 1857. In the context of audio, analog refers to the method of representing a sound wave with voltage fluctuations that are analogous to the pressure fluctuations of the sound wave. Analog fluctuations are infinitely varying rather than the discrete changes at sample time associated with digital recording. The next type is media players. This was introduced in the year 1998.
It is a computer program for playing multimedia files like videos, movies, and music. Media players commonly display standard media control icons known from physical devices such as tape recorders and CD players such as, and the functions we use in this media players are play, pause, fast forward, back forward, and stop buttons. And the next type is ebook reader, and this was introduced in the year 1998. And it is a portable electronic device for reading digital books and periodicals, better known as e-books. So the e-book reader is normally designed to operate over long hours by consuming minimal power. So most e-book readers rely on the e-ink technology for their displays. And the third type of handheld devices is communication devices. In that we have different categories, and the first one is mobile phone, that is, which is introduced in the year 1973. Later, mobile phones belonging to the global system for mobile communications network became capable of sending and receiving text messages. A mobile phone with advanced features similar to the computer is called smartphone, while a regular mobile phone is known as feature phone. The next type in communication devices, cordless telephone. This was introduced in the year 1968. It is also known as portable telephone, acts just like a normal phone except for the fact that it works without cords. A wired base station communicates with a wireless handset through radio waves, and this usually only works within a limited range. And the next type is pager, which comes under the category of communication devices and which was introduced in the year 1921. A page is a small telecommunication device that receives alert signals and or short messages. So this type of device is convenient for people expecting telephone calls but who are not near a telephone set to make or return calls immediately.
Handheld devices has some advantages and disadvantages. Let's see the advantages of handheld computers. The first advantage of handheld devices is portability. They are smaller than the typical laptop, allowing them to easily be tucked away into the backpack, briefcase, or even one's pocket. So within the classroom, they can replace notebooks and allow students to access the course material very faster. They also provide a new and innovative way to educate. For business people, they can be easily brought into airplanes and into meetings. The next advantage is having the smaller keyboards. In the case of handheld computers, the keyboards are smaller than those of laptop or desktop computers. So this can limit use to actions that require minimal typing because the small keyboard isn't conducive to productive word processing. For instance, instead of typing full document as one would on a desktop or laptop computer, the user might only be able to productively check email and surf the internet on a handheld devices. The next advantage is price. Typical desktop and laptop computers can run more than $1,000. The handheld computer is significantly cheaper than those. According to Consumer Search, the Palm TX PDA cost about $260. The Palm Tungsten E2 cost about $190. So while these are manufacturized computers, they are hundreds of dollars cheaper than the large versions. So handheld computers can be a cost-effective computing solution for a cash-strapped company, household, or school district. Disadvantages of handheld devices. The first thing is about the size. If it is too small, we may forget where it is or not even realize it is missing. The next disadvantage is it easily gets damaged. It's easy to scratch or even break the screens, so consider insurance or you will probably need to buy a whole new device. The next disadvantage is data input. The process will be very slower and more awkward than with the PC. This is all about the handheld devices and mobile computing. Thank you.